Aaron has asked, how do I know what size of wire is needed for the likes of the engine, fuel pump, general electrics in a car? It all comes down to Ohm's law and working out the current flow in the circuit that you're wiring up. So basically, if we know the voltage that's going to be provided there, generally with our automotive applications, 13.8 to 14.2 volts, and then we know the impedance or resistance of the circuit, so let's say an injector, we can measure that. We can use Ohm's law then to calculate the amount of current flow that's going to be in that circuit. So that's one way. For most of our engine wiring, generally we're going to be able to get away with 20 to 22 gauge wire. Some instances for sensors we could drop down to 24 gauge, but the problem with going to such a small gauge wire is that while yes it's lighter, for most applications we probably aren't going to notice the difference of the weight of the wire, and the thinner wire mechanically is less strong. So if you get someone who's a little bit heavy-handed working on the engine, it's actually possible to damage the wiring harness if they're not too careful. So 20, 22 gauge. Now when we go to something like a fuel pump, we can measure the resistance. We can also look at manufacturer specifications for the pump that we're working with, and that will give us an indication of what the current draw is expected to be in operation at the operating pressure that we're expecting to see. Wouldn't be uncommon to use maybe 14 or 16 gauge wire for a fuel pump. With headlights or lights in general, they will be a wattage rating, so we can then work from the wattage rating and come back to current. So once we know what the current is, then we can look at a sort of a reference graph or reference table of wire gauge versus current handling capabilities. We include this in our courses, but if you Google that, you'll be able to find something similar as well, so you know kind of what gauge wire is going to handle what current flow given the length of that run and the operating temperature.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.